and revelry that is occurring at Pin Seekers in DeForest, one of my favorite cities in the world, where you will find it takes two, him and you, to replace Tausch as our cousin subs of the day. It is Olympic gold medalist and fourth place finisher, Matt Hamilton, presented by Coors Light, clearly, and one of the rising stars of ESPN Wisconsin, Alex Strolf.
Yeah,
good morning,
that?
Fellas. How are you?
Good morning, Jason. I actually want to start with something you said in your wonderful intro, despite you calling me a rising star. Who told you I was grumpy?
I didn't want to say.
You think I'm grumpy? I mean, I think you've been
you might be now.
Back,
in that first half, right when he showed up, he was a little bit of a Krabby Patty.
Okay, let me walk you through my morning. So I woke up in the wonderful city of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. It took me 2 hours and 10 minutes to make a 1 hour and 10 minute drive to DeForest. I got three different phone calls in the matter of 10 minutes of arriving here that nothing was working. So I was told Matt Hamilton might get sent back to the Everlight Solar Studio in downtown Madison. But I get here, and all of a sudden, in 90 seconds, I got everything to work. So I am no longer crabby. I've got my morning show. I'm ready to go this morning at Pin Seekers. 50-cent Coors Light, baby. Let's go.
So and on top of that, not only did we have a remote earlier in the week at Patio Pleasures where the radio machine had an utter meltdown.
Yeah,
you can find that apparently on the Wilde and Tausch Twitter feed. We've posted the video there. But then I'm told that young Riley, who we all love and we see the potential in and we're excited for his future, overslept and is going to be late for work. And then he makes it in the nick of time. And as I said to him, I don't know if I'm supposed to be disappointed in him now or proud of him now that he overcame the oversleeping and got here to work on time. Riley, was it the AM PM knob? What exactly happened that threw you off this morning?
It wasn't the AM PM deal. I checked that last night before I went to bed. I intentionally set my alarm for 7:30 AM so I'd have plenty of time to get ready this morning, shower, get here on time. I have a car on campus at the moment, so I was like, I'll be chilling. Don't need to bike in the snow. It'll be awesome. And then I wake up. It's one of those things where you turn off the alarm without realizing you're turning off the alarm. And I wake up and it's 8:40 already. And I'm like, oh, no. I'm like, I'm going to be late. Everyone's going to be pissed at me. This sucks. And thankfully, Hunter Vaughn, I'm still working on the stream. So you definitely should be more disappointed in me right now. Everything's still a little not ideal right now, but thank you, Hunter Vaughn, for getting most of the stream ready to go and saving my butt. So
I am curious, do most people use alarm clocks still, or is it all, like, I tell my Google, hey Google, bed, and then she asks me what time I want to get up, but I don't trust it when I have to go somewhere in case there's like a power outage. So I back it up on like my phone, which I know will have enough battery juice. But I never use an alarm clock. Am I the only one now that has moved past the alarm clock?
No, I'm all phone. But hold on a minute. We're letting Riley really sneak by here, Jason and Matt. He said he overslept. He completely blatantly turned off his alarm and went back to sleep.
Hey,
he didn't oversleep. He went back to bed.
Here's the thing, Strophy. When you have, like, the phone alarm, just 1 inch away from that snooze button is the off or end. Or dismiss, and it's it. So when you grab your phone and it just stops, maybe you accidentally hit the, like, turn the alarm off button. He might have thought he hit snooze and tried to just get back to sleep for an extra 10, and then realized he got an extra hour.
So Riley, I ask you, are you a one alarm guy or do you set multiple alarms?
No, I'm a one alarm guy. I have the throwback. It's literally just an alarm clock. It works as a clock.
I was trying to give you the benefit of the doubt.
I appreciate that, Matt. Unfortunately, you were wrong. I accidentally turned it off. I didn't hit snooze. And, I did go back to bed.
Well, you have an actual alarm clock. How old are you?
Yeah, love letters and alarm clocks.
Yeah,
this guy
I guess I'm an old man.
Hey, 1957 called. They'd like you to come back.
Yeah. Is it one of those analog clocks with the little hammer that goes between the bells? Or is it like the digital clock that everybody had, their parents had in their bedroom growing up with like the wood sticker on it that made it look legit? Like which kind
of clocks? There's like these little like, it's almost like a blind on your windows where the numbers click over. Like what? You're going to have to, do you have roommates? Can they send us a photo of your clock?
I could, yeah.
And I did say clock.
I could probably have one of them send us a picture and I can put it on the video stream at some point. It's a digital clock. It's not the one with the little hammer going back and forth where it like shakes in the midair and falls off my nightstand. It's a regular digital clock. But yeah, I guess I'm an old man.
I thought Jesse was the oldest young man in our midst, but you are giving him a run for his money.
That's crazy. I don't think I've used anything but my phone for an alarm in a decade.
Yeah, me neither.
I don't set too. Are you a snoozer? Do you hit snooze?
No, so I'm a multiple alarm guy. So like this morning here,
I can
pull it up for you. I was 6:05, 6:12, 6:15, 6:20, 6:23, 6:27, 6:30 alarms this morning. I got up at the 6:05 one, but I do set 6 or 7 alarms every day just in case I'm feeling it in the morning. Yeah.
That's basically hitting snooze. Wow. Are you a snooze guy?
So, first of all, Strofe sharing that aspect, you're a psychopath. I've never heard anybody do that many that are separate alarms. Although
really? I've heard of like 2 or 3.
I feel like that's normal.
You rattled off like 8 times there.
Yeah, but it was all within a 25-minute window because sometimes I wake up and I'm thinking to myself, yeah, I could probably do another 10 minutes. But as Riley learned the hard way this morning, another 10 minutes typically turns into another hour or hour and a half in Riley's case. So I really try to get my – I've learned from my past mistakes. I've pulled Riley's in my past life, Jason. So I've decided in order to correctly grow up
and become
an adult, I need to solidify my 25 to 30 minute window and just knock out as many alarms as I can.
We'll have less sleep and we'll be grumpy.
No, exactly. look at Riley. Almost like he knows what he's doing over there.
So what I don't understand is like the snooze is like 9 minutes. If you put your
That's too long.
But if you set 2 alarms 5 minutes apart, then you're going to get, like, you will have all of your alarms if you hit snooze and wanted to stay down. Like, obviously, you have set up here. If you wanted to continue to sleep but still wanted to wake up, you only need 2 with the snooze.
Hey, all I'm saying is don't knock it till you try it, because it sounds like you're knocking it without trying.
No,
I'm definitely
knocking it. I hit snooze once, and then I wake up.
I appreciate your honesty. Yeah.
I hit snooze one time, and then I wake up. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. That's just the way I roll. I either get up at the first bell or one snooze.
So I have now become, we have our little Google Home Nest deals throughout the house. And Sydney likes to use it as an intercom, which is a little annoying, frankly.
Well, that's fun.
Because it goes through the entire house. Come see my hamster. He's running around in the playpen. But I, you talk to your Google, so when the Google alarm goes off, I say, hey, Google, snooze for 10 minutes. And then what's really amazing, now she's talking to me because she heard me say, hey, Google, here in the radio studio. I don't know if that's better or worse than tapping the bar or touching your phone, because I still manage to fall back to sleep even though I have spoken words, which you would think would be something that would get you to be more awake.
Yeah, I think it's better because you're not going to say Google turn off alarm. You're saying snooze for 10 minutes, where I can accidentally turn my alarm off. Right? Like still in a sleepy stupor, and I grab my phone and hit off, like, I'm donezo. Thinking I hit snooze, I'm falling back asleep, and I'm asleep until I wake up naturally.
Exactly.
Well, we would like to thank you three all for your service. Strofe, did you know, you knew it was going to snow, so you set your alarm earlier? Because that's a treacherous drive if it's snowing, and you're rushing because you have to get to Pin Seekers. So you left nice and early? That was very savvy of you. responsible.
I got to listen to our friends Jen, Gabe, and Chewy all morning. Great show on 94.5 ESPN.
Especially from about 7:15 to 7:30.
Yeah, I really enjoyed the part where Jason Wilde was breaking down whether or not there will be a kicker battle this training camp. That was a hell of a way to start my Friday, Jason. That was some good insight by you.
We'll save that for later in the show so you have something to look forward to on today's
nice.
Program.
Let's go!
So, Jason, you should have seen the face Strofe gave me when I was like, why did you stay in Milwaukee if your show was done at 7? Why didn't you just drive home before the
snow? Beat the snow! Yeah,
The look I got, it was like, duh, Matt. Like, obviously, I'm a young man. I was hanging out in Milwaukee. But the other look was like, I didn't think about that. And it was pure like, wow.
My mind.
You're a genius. You're an old man. Of course you would have hung out in Milwaukee.
I may have realized it was going to storm after a few Coors Lights. I just dealt with the repercussions this morning. But I'm here. I'm on time. I didn't oversleep. I don't know how this turned into the hey, Strofe, you should have drove back last night. I don't know what we're doing. Here.
We're happy to have you.
Yeah, it's good to be here. It's good to be here.
And you bounced right back. Like, after I sent that message to Jason,
yeah, I'm not cranky.
Crabby, you totally bounced out of it.
All right, well, it's great to see you. It's great to see Jason, albeit virtually. It's great to hear the sultry tones of Riley Yauch, who gave us a great SportsCenter update about Wisconsin wrestling. Like, we're off and running on a Friday, fellas. I'm feeling good.
Was there a UFC update in there, too? Jack and Madison, I want to apologize to you for making your alarm snooze for 10 minutes because of my voice. Apparently, your Google was listening. What are you guys doing at Pin Seekers? Because it looks like a really fun place. I heard I've already been criticized for not coming down. So I understand. And that's very fair, especially, you know, with my burgeoning golf game making a comeback. But what are you guys doing there?
So the awesome part about Pin Seekers is you can golf here rain, shine, or snow. They got heaters out in the bays, which is they're actually surprisingly warm. I actually had to take a couple layers off when I was hitting a couple balls earlier. Shirtless driving range. No shirt, no shoes, no problem here at Pin Seekers. But they are serving 50-cent Coors Lights to start the day until the 10 o'clock hour, and I believe they go up to $1, and then they're tacking on 50 cents. But, like, right now is the time to come have a beer, have a morning beer, and hit some golf balls out of Pin Seekers.
Jason, check this out. We've got $4 worth of Coors Lights given to us. We will wait until after the show to consume, of course. But we've got 8 beers in front of us, $4. Unbelievable deals at Pin Seekers.
Is there, as a non-drinker, do we have a policy? Like, is there an actual in the employee handbook, teammate handbook? Is there a policy of no drinking Coors Lights during the time you're on the air, or is that just assumed?
I think it's just assumed, but also what you just assumed is you just asked Matt Hamilton and Alex Strofe if they read the employee handbook. Like, understand the question and the crowd you just asked said question to.
I just don't want to give out company secrets, so I'm not going to say anything about it. But, yeah, of course I did.
What a professional you are. We respect that. All right, well, we're glad everyone is here. We will miss Tausch and Jesse, who are out today on I hate it when we use that on assignment. That's such bunk. Jesse's in Dubuque betting on games where
yeah,
it's
I hope
legal
he's having
there.
A great time. Yeah, hope he's having a great time.
And Tausch is on vacation. So we look forward to them returning someday. But we've got a dream team of our own assembled right here at Pin Seekers at the Everlight Solar ESPN Madison Studios with Sleepy Riley Yauch, and of course here in Green Bay. We will talk some Packers, but I've got a few things that I was looking forward to discussing with you two live at Pin Seekers, and we'll do those next. It's Wilde and Tausch.
I feel fantastic.
Wilde and Tausch is presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Call Gina Della from Pella at 855-PELLA-WI or visit online at PellaWI.com/radio. He's the most interesting man in sports radio.
Well, should I have a chip on my shoulder that I'm not making as much money as Skip Bayless?
in his mind anyway. The Homer Hour with special guests every day from 5 to 6.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you could say it's getting better and better.
Well, no, you don't have to. You played on it. Maybe it didn't.
I don't think it ever did.
Okay.
I really don't.
The Homer Hour with Homer. Weekdays from 5 to 6 right here on 94.5 ESPN and streaming live on YouTube. It's a promise we made in 1964 and continues now, 60 years later, making car buying easy for families across Southeast Wisconsin. Celebrate Ewald Automotive's 60th anniversary with special savings on over 1,300 vehicles. Shop the easy way with the lowest prices guaranteed. Plus, you're backed by Ewald's exclusive 20-year, 200,000-mile warranty. Hurry in to Ewald's 60th anniversary sale.
Go to ewaldauto.com.
Hey, this is Brad Nortman, here to tell you about my friends at Bank 5-9. Everywhere I go throughout the area, I see Bank 5-9, and it's no wonder why. Not only do they have 14 branch locations, but their employees spend nearly 9,000 hours each year volunteering in the communities that they serve. That's on top of the financial support that they provide to several hundred nonprofits right here in southeastern Wisconsin. If you're looking for a true local community bank, check them out today at bank59.com. Member FDIC.
Brewers fans, listen up. On April 2nd, the Milwaukee Broadhouse and the Milwaukee Brewers are teaming up to bring you the ultimate tailgate experience. Forget the parking lot hassle, drink with us at the Tailgate House. For just $69 per person, including an all-you-can-eat and drink package, enjoy live music and see 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee's live broadcast. Don't worry about transportation either. There's free round-trip shuttle transportation from the Milwaukee Broadhouse and its sister locations. Worst Bar, Jack's American Pub, and Wanakee Golf Course is available. Secure your spot at the Tailgate House today at Milwaukee Broadhouse.
A season of award-winning golf at Sweetgrass and Sage Run is on the horizon. The Island Resort and Casino's stay-and-play golf packages are booking fast, with choice dates available early in the week. After your rounds, visit the Drift Spa for a relaxing or targeted massage session. And enjoy dinner at Horizon's scenic top-floor steakhouse. So many reasons to take a drive. Book your stay-and-play golf package today. Visit islandresortgolf.com.
Don't miss the Milwaukee Bucks at Fiserv Forum on March 24th as we celebrate Women's Empowerment Night, presented by BMO. Hear how sport has empowered and influenced women and celebrate what that means to our community. Cheer for some incredible Milwaukee Bucks basketball and support women's empowerment on Sunday, March 24th. For more details and to purchase tickets, visit bucks.com/impact. That's bucks.com/impact.
Big trucks can be intimidating. If you've been seriously injured in a truck crash, call Gruber Law Offices today. Trucking law can be extremely complicated. You don't want to take on the insurance company alone. Gruber Law Offices has the experience, the resources, and of course, the results. We know truck law. We know the rules and regulations. We know what it takes to win. Call Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Whether you're a local who wants to enjoy a night out or you're planning to visit Milwaukee, enjoy an artfully stylish experience at St. Kate the Arts Hotel. The hotel is ideally located in the heart of the theater district in downtown Milwaukee. With deluxe accommodations, culinary creativity, on-site galleries, and nightly live music, you'll enjoy every element of your stay at St. Kate. Book special hotel packages with room rates starting as low as $129 a night. Learn more and book your stay at stkatearts.com.
You're listening to Wilde and Tausch on 94.5 ESPN. Presented by Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin and sponsored by American Family Insurance.
I'm dancing on my own, make the moves of the past.
The Dream Team, which was the name of a show that I did in the infancy of ESPN Madison, a different affiliation at the time. We like did it from the Regent apartment complex. There was like a little radio studio in the basement next to the Subway restaurant. And we had a rotating group of hosts. And that's how I started in radio. And I may have overslept once or twice like Riley did for that show. You guys, as we get underway at Pin Seekers, we lost our video connection with you, so you were working on repairing that. Are you going to hit balls at any point during the program?
Like during the program or in the break? Because I plan on hitting them in the break. During the program sounds like a dream. That would handle this. I can go hit some balls.
Yeah, well, the issue with me, Jason, is there was a video once upon a time on the Rutledge and Hamilton Twitter of me missing a golf ball after eight consecutive swings when we were golfing out at U Ridge last summer. So I think I'll probably stay put where I'm sitting right now.
I was thinking in the because in honor of Tausch not being here, I was thinking a digi only, as he likes to call them. By the way, I would love for you to digitally get back on video because right now Riley's just showing a big screen of me, and that's a bit much. It's just me all by myself. So, Riley, maybe turn on the video camera in the radio studio so at least you can join me in the video because staring back at me, not a real great look, and I don't think it's driving traffic to YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook either.